dekat. So our SOP for our enforcement, they will look at the car because we don't know who's car. So they will go around. Those who can park in the OKU car park is those people who have the sticker and also who have the, if you don't have the sticker, but you have an NDP sticker, maybe you are from Kedah or you're from other state, you don't have the sticker, but you put your OKU card on your dashboard. Then you have that, then you park on the parking lot of OKU, then you go plan the car. Other than that, they will plan. Okay, let me see this procedure. Okay. So we saw from the CCTV that you came, then you park your car, you first drive, you park your car, then you come out from the knee at 12 o'clock. And then my officer came around 2 o'clock to clam. I mean, after 2 hours, you park your car and we didn't see from CCTV, you're pushing your mother and all that, you didn't see lah from CCTV. But now...
Sorry, just now you mentioned in the CCTV, you didn't see, I push my mother.
No, we didn't see from our CCTV lah, because probably, but on top of that also, there is no card, because the car, when my enforcement saw your car there, your car is already parked there and with no cars, there is no, as I mentioned to you, like no sticker and no card for the OKU. So that's why they claim. Then after that one at you park at 12 o'clock. Clamp at 2 o'clock, do something lah. And then they came back. Then now, since you say that your mother, we already prepared. You said that you already in the process of applying. But when we check, you came to our office yesterday. Yesterday after the incident, you came to inquire. But in the ni, you said you are already processing, checking. We check tak perlu lagi lah. Whatever it is, atas keprihatinan. We already prepare for you the sticker, but you have to fill in the form and then follow the procedure. In order to get the OKU sticker, you must have the OKU card lah. So that actually we already ready. We are prihatin. So already ready dekat my officer. So we went back. There's now we have the sticker. So it's not shouldn't be any problem. You fulfill the fill in the form, then we will give you even today the sticker. Actually just now I brought back my son. Yes, that is the because we also have to be fair to everybody, because we also receive a feedback from the OKU themselves. There are many cars who don't have the OKU sticker parked on the OKU car park. They actually have the sticker, even themselves is OKU driver, they cannot park. So I think my staff is following the procedure of going around and check now. But maybe there is a room for improvement. We will discuss further in our Jatah Kuasa Lalu Lintas how to improve this SOP. Maybe when they saw the somebody pushing the OKU or pushing or those people who are at the stage of OKU, but they don't have, maybe we can also get the kebenaran for the pengat kuasa to unclaim your car. Maybe that one we have to discuss at our technical level, at our community level. That's what I can show to you lah. I mean, I can assure you lah.
Okay. Yeah. So when come back to the one that you said according to CCTV, you never see
ah. Kita tak nampak lah dia punya, because it's quite far.
Okay. Then wait. Okay. If you say tak nampak, okay. The parking van start. They help me to take my mother down from the car. They are so kind enough to help me to take my mother down and then help me to push
her. Understand what? You when my staff at that time when they claim your car, they didn't see all this.
I know. Yes. I understand. Mm. But then when these two officers came, I did show them. Because see my mother on the wheelchair, still want to pay for saman.
Okay, but you should understand the procedure of my pengat kuasa.
once they issue the compound, they cannot, at their level, they cannot waive the compound. Otherwise, there will be a very lot of problem because this involve money. That is involve money.
But the thing is, the receipt not open yet, huh?
Yeah, but the compound is already there. The number. The receipt is not. But when they go back, when they reach the compound, they have to look in the compound, the compound. So how do you unclaim? Where is the receipt of the money? So we don't want also to have abuse of power on our enforcement. We should understand our procedure.
Okay, yeah. Fine.
So that's why I was saying to you just now, maybe we would like to look to review into our guideline. When my enforcement officer looks at you pushing the need, maybe there will be a room for improvement. That looking at that, maybe they can unclaim or pick out the claim without for you to pay. But this one, at the moment, the procedure is not like that.
Yeah,
so we will kaji.
Yeah, I understand your. I understand what you say.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, so when these two officers see my mother's condition like that, at least he said, okay, let me check with my boss. Am I right? Correct or not? At least they said, okay, let me check with my boss. At least you give a call to your boss and ask for. But still insist, no, you have to pay, otherwise you cannot apply. What kind of attitude is this?
Okay, on that score, I think. I don't want to prolong this matter. I'm having a meeting, but since you are here, I mentioned to you, atas prihatinan, we already earlier we already get ready the card for you, the talking speaker for you. But you come today, maybe we can go to our department. Then you already take the form yesterday, kan? You can get the form to us. Then immediately we can give you the opening speaker.
You are referring the form of Kebati.
The form that they have, in order to get the OKU sticker, there is a form that you have to fill in from our office.
From NDPP?
Yes.
But I went to your office yesterday. They still have to get the, what they call that, the form. Actually, it's in my car. It says stated that you have to go to contact masyarakat.
Yeah, you have to get the mother OKU card. Then in order to get the OKU sticker, you have to do that.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. So what am I trying to say? Okay, I have to go through complex masyarakat ni, then I have to go to the doctor to write down the reports everything, and then after that I have to go to NDPP, which is in Kota. So how long can I take this?
You can do it now. I can give you now.
Okay.
In fact, the receipt is the sticker is already ready. If you can do it now, I can ensure you today. I can give you the sticker.
So you need to come here and collect.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So how about the doctor report? The doctor will not immediately write.
I want that you do not on your side, I can help you on the side, but I can only help you to issue the sticker. If you can fill in the procedure, I can give you the sticker anytime.
Okay. So
the sticker is already ready.
Okay. Yeah. So how about this report? Can this be used?
But I think apart from this, I think you have the Jabatan Kebajikan Masyarakat, Mr. Ong, the Jabatan Kebajikan Masyarakat to say that your mother is OKU, then you can give her.
Okay, so I will still need to bring her to Kompleks
Masyarakat. JKM Kompleks Masyarakat Menyayang. Ya, betul lah.
So bring her there, then after that I have to go to the doctor.
Then you can give it, you can, then I already get ready.
So I can get it?
Yes. That one, I can, those within my decision, I can give it, I can assure you. But in JKM and all that, you have to do it lah. But if one you get that, I can give it to you, no problem.
Okay,
I can deliver to you today. The moment I'm working today. Okay. Even you get it at night, so you give me a call, I can give it to you.
Okay, can, so how can I contact?
Get my number 012 012
0
Nanti okay okay kasi kita cuba sentai kan okay 012 okay 012 48 49 405. Okay, you think me a miscall? Untuk bandar. Untuk bandar. Untuk bandar.
besar besar besar.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. So your name?
Eunice
Lim
and I.
Eunice. Where are you?
E.
You.
Yeah.
E.
E.
E. U N I C E.
Yeah.
Eunice. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Get ready for you the future. So, okay, yeah? Okay? So, we try see macam mana boleh bantu, okay?